shall arrive. This time bearing gifts. I have brought with me a treasure of misfortune, a player of passion and pain. Through musical mayhem, this haunted record player. It will titillate and amaze.
Oh. My. God.
These songs I lay before you can be played to bring about its magic.
Bodies make hobbies, madman, I'm sobbing. Never planning on stopping. The vampires unlocking. Levels on levels, push on the pedal, but you can't escape. Drug of my choice is blood, sir, bitch. You my pancake. Awake the clutch, now we in gear. Leak from your ears, leak from the rear. Peek through your shears, eyes cut up here. Terrors now here, put your guns up. Silver ain't the color, cause my red dot will cross ya. Foster your roster, groom them, it'll cost ya. One, two, or three bodies they may off ya. Back as my spring, cue the murder, please. Ain't no kerosene, we don't burn, we clean. Puncture wounds.
You know those moments when you know the decision you're making seems like it should be wrong, but at the time the choices you saw are liable, and after all other attempts have failed, then suddenly the wrong choice does not seem as though it was wrong at the time. I know this has been experienced by many, for there are many in hell who lament on this topic. Many angels would say to wait for the Lord, have faith and he shall be there. However, they have not seen what Lilith has gone through, and so, in one of those moments where all seemed lost to her and suicide was the only choice she saw, I came to her and the Holy Spirit said something through me that truly astounded even me. He brought up the memories of my pain as Lucifer and guided me towards saying, you must keep going on, you cannot give up, if nothing else find the path to hatred to keep you going. At times before all this, it was my hatred for God that saw me through, gave me the strength to never give up, to never allow him to win. Do not worry, you can find forgiveness later, he will understand, he knows all that you are going through, so he shall understand. He will forgive you, but for now, if that is what it takes, then hate me. Let the hatred fuel your desire to never give up, to never give in. I stood back as I realized I was witnessing the birth of Lilith and that I shall see the very demon that accompanies that legend with what I do now. It shall feed from her injustice, it shall find its fuel and the very bread of its life that shall sustain it within the material world from the sins of others upon her. If no, one shall take the effort to realize the inhibitions that limit her ability to function as everyone else, if they refuse to acknowledge her disability and use and manipulate her as one would expect to occur to a person who is wrought with sin, and allow the injustice to happen upon the weak and innocent, then they shall know this demon's fury. It shall not know of death, for it shall come forth from its demonic unlife from death itself, and shall build the path of her salvation from oppression and injustice from the shattered pieces of their lives that it shall leave in its wake. Though I shall withhold its ability to take life, it shall not be capable of knowingly ending anyone's life, for that is the lesson to be learned here by others, especially those who deserve its wrath, is that life is a gift, and to bring suffering to others' lives for the benefit of their own without regard to others is distasteful in my eyes, and suffer and brimstone and the stench of foul things shall accompany its presence. Born forth from the very sins of man upon himself as a penance for their ignorance, it shall take the physical embodiment of the sin they so arrogantly brought upon her to suffer, and I shall call this unholy guardian Urgitoth, demon of retribution for the innocent and vengeance for the martyred who suffer without salvation from evil. For far too long have I watched the turmoil of the innocent souls of living and the dead. No more, I have been given this power for a purpose, and power is not something that is meant to serve a person's own desires. power should be used for the sake of others if it becomes necessary for such things. But first I must apply my option of finding my own path towards redemption and pause to apply the teachings of Jesus to ascertain how he would apply his wisdom to this situation. Gathered from what I remember of that life, he would say something like, "Halt your anger, Father, a stone cast for a stone thrown does not end the conflict but merely fuels the purpose for more conflict. If a man is caught raising his hand in anger towards another, would it be the right choice to cut off that hand for forcing that man to commit sin? No, for sin lies within a person's heart, and that is where the battle must be fought. Nay, I say, stay the man's hand from striking and embrace his pain that causes him to desire violence, otherwise we only fuel the evil to continue to dwell in our hearts where the true demons lay within us. Strike at the heart of evil, not its crude weapons, if you truly wish for your aim to be true, and strike down evil." To which I would reply, "Yes, son, but that still leaves a problem unsolved." To which he would say, "Then you haven't solved the problem yet, have you? All right then, let me approach this again. Scrub the demon and let's add some green trees over here with a little burning bush like so. And we'll go ahead and paint some flowers in there too, and call this the ghost of nightmares past, and shall lead a person's life towards desolation for each time it must manifest into the physical world for the sins they commit upon her, and these things shall be accompanied by a vision, seven altogether. There are seven deadly sins, and so, seven times they shall be given warning that will be brought first by the ringing of church bells, a representation of the cries of the angels that I heard in heaven when this first began. So in recognition to that, each time this demon is called to visit upon someone to bring them woe and take from them an opportunity in life that was brought about by their own design, it shall be accompanied by a vision, whether awake or asleep does not matter, they will still see and hear this apparition's approach that shall be announced by the ringing of cathedrals' church bells. Seven times shall it be heard, seven times shall it take from them, and on the seventh and final bell heard they shall find themselves, and the only paths left for them to choose from will only lead to a path to Azazel, the father of desolation and a shepherd of lost souls. Only through him can a path to salvation from certain death be found." Cover your neck and face like a bandana, blood drip thick like syrup, mouth in the fountain like slurp. Welcome to the family like church, children of the night, welcome back. Always feed the hunger and know that the sun burns. Sleep in the day and at night we emerge. Embody the rebirth, now you're living in reverse. Vibing on adrenaline, so give me the light. Back in the coffin by the morning, not a fan of the light. I'm gonna paint this tolerant. Leaving a fight, went from your shitless to a hit, just one bite. Vibing on adrenaline, so give me the light. Back in the coffin by the morning, not a fan of the light. I'm gonna paint this tolerant. Leaving a fight, went from your shitless. From the floor to ceiling, flay that face, call it pumpkin peeling. Save that grace, I'm so fucked your feelings, and I'll just lay waste. Straight constant killing, I'm a basket case, ready and willing in the casket race. So many boxes to fill in like the masturbate, in the blood of the spirits in the gravitate. From a hero to a villain, I'm a vampire. Fuck around and catch you by the campfire. I hate to do it, I'm a bad liar. Going through it, let it transpire. But now I'll lose it like a bad tire. I walk in the shadows in the valley of death. Stay amongst the like-minded when bound by the crest. Heart stopper like an axe in the chest. Keep chopping till you're nothing or I'm all out of breath. Now who's next? I've been on adrenaline, so give me the light. Back in the coffin by the morning, not a fan of the light. I'm gonna paint this town red. Leaving a
that's my opinion!
How dare you enter!
Now, get ready
for the ball!
I'm not scared.
maybe you need a timeout.
Now look at this.
Evil ain't bad in moderation. I limit these hands in moderation, but the devil inside loves combinations. Never seen it like me, bitch, I'm an alien. Been a donda, ski mask and make you run. Been a donda like a cop at stadium. See a little blood and go macadamia. Fuck with the boy, that's a huge mistake. Told you I'm not of the human race. Keep pulling that trigger, I'll mutilate. Hands chopped with a shooting pain. This venom inside is ready to rise, so think big, are you ready to die? The last time I was ready to riot, now I'm fighting the corners inside. And my demons, but they stay eating. It's dark in me and it ain't leaving. I try to bury it and stay breathing. And no heart means I ain't beating this nigga.
Y'all talk so violent, my sons, y'all so childish. Put coins on your eyelids, that means I don't buy it, bitch.
I'm riding on the inside, and the truth is a given to this line. And you need a demon to fight the devil, the one to rock you on this guy. And I'm tired of being in disguise, I'll accept the evil on pick sides.
Now the Jekyll's there, but it's me instead. Never wear the skin, you know, this high, bitch.
Darker is all I know, every time I fall, I know that. Everything is all my fault, so every time I fall, I grow back. Every time I call my home, everyone ignores my phone. Now I don't need your help, I can do it on my own.
We in Venom, yeah, this world will take advantage if you let them. We were just, but now we're handing down the center. Now your fate is in the hands of those you pen up. We are Venom, yeah.
Bitch, what the fuck you wanna do? I'm a demon, better know I'm one in front of you. Think you really doing something with a gun or two? You pull the trigger, I'ma let you meet the other dude. I don't think you really wanna come at you. You just wanna flex a little, move the pecs a little. Couldn't read a textbook, so it's taxi wheel. Cutthroat, when they talking at their neck, I kill them.
J.G. Wentworth, the check is real. I only give you one option, I get the spill blood.
Took the red pill, so I know the real ones. And you ain't got the roster to lift the steel drum.
Ramble, everybody here can get touched. Your life is unrefundable, we dump, you get flushed. Everybody want it gone, gone, a real thug. The wind blow wrong, and the stronger with the.
Oh, shit, he put a chrome, did he? All with his blood got me so giddy. Thought you was like me, you so drippy. I'm fleeing the scene, but with your kidney. Big Poppy wanna slide and batter up. Got him pancake, but you battered up. Pull them cameras, open apertures. You gon' need it for the med examiners. So you in the back, boy, it's fabulous. Shine a Lord's way, but it's blasphemous. Where them tanks at, blow them canisters. Feel like stallions, but we savages. Think it's fucked, said we don't back it up. Bullets ain't shit, they don't pass to us. Run that whole clip, now your ammo up. Run them long legs with tarantulas, bitch.
Darker is all I know, every time I fall, I know that. Everything is all my fault, so every time I fall, I grow back. Every time I call my home, everyone ignores my phone. Damn, now I don't need your help, I can do it on my own.
We are Venom, yeah, this world will take advantage if you get up. We were just, but now we're handing down the center. Now your fate is in the hands of those you pen up. We are Venom,
I'm the king of a rumba beat. When I play the maracas, I go chick chicky boom, chick chicky boom.
I have heard the Gospels, I've heard the Gospel of Sophia, and I've heard the Temptation of Christ. These are wrong, one is misunderstood and the other is a false lie made to undermine me. Yet they are both tied together involving the same scenario. During the temptation of Christ, I had appeared to John the Baptist at the River Jordan as a test to myself to try and gauge the limits of my power, projecting across the reflection of time I knew I could do, but to what extent? So I tried projecting an entire imprinted image of my room, including Lilith, who was asleep on the bed when it happened. What John saw was the image of me with Lilith asleep behind me, and I instructed him to fetch the boy from the city by the name of Mashkarit and bring him to the river in 3 days' time. On the third day I returned and he brought the boy forward, and I explained to him that I was his father, one of his heavenly fathers, and that through me the Lord did pass the essence of his light into his mother, Mary. This is where the lie of Sophia comes into play. Because I was explaining to him that I was an angel of God and that I was one of his angelic parents, and mankind's inability to understand the angelic design of being anatomically correct and the image of Lilith asleep behind me, they assumed that I was the angelic form of his heavenly mother, whom they called Sophia, a simple misunderstanding. The temptations of Christ was not what they said at all. Even though the words were wise advice, it is still false, and the support to that comes from the pilgrimage of Jesus across the Red Sea. What was his pilgrimage for? What was he after? These questions that John the Baptist refused to answer right after Jesus left got him beheaded by Herod and his soldiers. That answer is that I sent him on a quest to retrieve the sword of legend, the sword of spirits that was left to Pan, the guardian spirit of the woods, also called the sword of David. His retrieval of the sword of David would have ended his uncle Herod's ability to pursue and hunt him as he was doing, for the sword would have proven his lineage to the tribe of David and thus an heir to the seat of the Pharaoh. That was what his pilgrimage went to find across the sea, and that is the actual topics of discussion that have been mistranslated into my tempting him with the kingdoms of the world. To support this also I draw attention to the cavern that Josephus had hidden that was discovered with the Dead Sea Scrolls. One of the items listed to have been found along with the scrolls in 1946 was a rusty ceremonial-like sword that is within a museum I hear now. That sword is the sword of David that he was sent to retrieve, and the true valuable reason those things were hidden. That sword once held the power to crown the bearer to be named king of all of Israel, and was a duplicate attempt to reforge the original sword that could not be held by anyone other than the chosen light warrior and its maker, the sword of Marduk, or the flaming sword of Machiel that slew the dragon and cast it into the bottomless pit. So the temptations of Christ was misunderstood, most likely because I had to use the spirits of the dead in his era to speak their language properly, as I always have had to do. Now it is the Gospel of Sophia that is just a downright lie that is scripted to undermine not only myself but that of Jesus and the whole ensemble. This Gospel, drafted under the misunderstood scenario of Christ's temptation, has at the center of it a character claiming to be Sophia, what's her face, and a testimony of what occurred before the earth was created. This false Gospel subverts the title of the Light-Bearer, the position of Christ, and the misrepresentation of God's position to being seen as Lucifer's position, leaving Jesus to be misunderstood as the one whom they associate Satan with, as this entire gospel pronounces the position of the Son, born not of Joseph, but conceived by Mary, who, when compared alongside their gospel's events, would be who they claim Mary to be, Sophia by herself, in her defiance to God's authority. Why is it I have the subject of the Roman Antichrist nagging at me from the back of my mind?
Push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction.
Push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction.